thought we played great. We just didn't reward ourselves with, you know, the final play. A couple really good chances to go up, even after, again, we give up a soft goal. But Steve would be harder than anyone on himself. Harder on himself than I will be or his teammates. But yeah, some really good stuff. Sometimes that's how it goes. You go to PKs, and you know, it's not your night in the PK world. Credit them for hanging in there. I thought they defended pretty well all night long, and they were pretty committed to being difficult to being played through. But man, there was some really high level stuff from our end, and something to build on. We have a little exhale now for 3-4 days. Be good for them not to see me, probably more than anything. And we'll get back to work next Monday or this Monday, and prepare for our final road trip, and then coming home on the stadium, which is closer and closer.
You actually, you know, pushed Lucho for 120 there, and he seemed pretty active for the whole stretch. Is he, you know, I know he had said kind of toward the end of last year that there were times where he just was hurt and he wasn't healthy. Is he considerably more fit, considerably more healthy right now than he was last season?
Yeah, he doesn't have any health issues. And he's, I think he played at a really high level on both sides of the ball today. And that's really where, you know, we need to continue to preach and be about, and we're going to score goals and get chances because we have some playmakers. We have guys that are offensively capable. You know, now can we be a really solid defensive team and lock up the other side? And for the most part, we did that tonight. I thought everybody put in a heck of a shift. And yeah, if the great chances you create don't go in, you go to PKs. And anything can happen in PK.
Was keeping Paul out of the lineup today to give other players?
No. It was, you know, he had a little bit of his groin was suspect, and we just decided to hold him off. You know, I think the Open Cup needs another sub in the whole mix. I think it's certainly time for that. Again, throughout the season, pushing these guys 120 minutes, you just start to pick up injuries, and the extra sub does help. I think it's something they should look at. I thought the refereeing was really poor tonight. I thought Durkin, his was warranted. I mean, I'm not talking about that, but just in general, I thought the refereeing was really poor. Maddox was offside or onsides for the goal.
Looked at it even from
from every angle, from real time, from playback. He's on sides, and it's a goal. So, you know, you push the Open Cup, and you want to do it, and then every year the refereeing is not up to snuff in the early rounds.
So there's two things. Fourth sub, better referee squads, more first-team referee guys. What else?
Ms. Olson, you have anything?
Less PKs here.
Look, it's on us. There's enough chances to win that game. It wasn't on the referee tonight. But, again, it's, you know, it was tough for them to stay up with the play. And Maddox is fast. And again, I don't know how their guy's not thrown out there in the second half. But, again, if that's a little sour grapes. But I do think the Open Cup refereeing needs to address them and the put another sub in. But wasn't on them.
It seems like the couple games I've seen, Chris has had a couple bookings recently and maybe kind of towed that line a little
bit. He's learning his physicality, right? He's learning everything before our eyes. And it's beautiful to watch, and it's also heartbreaking.
Do you worry about, you know, with as young as he is and with some of his naivety, like getting a reputation of any sort with referees or with things, you know?
I think, again, this is all learning. You know, who you are as a player and what your physicality, how you can use your physicality. And be on that edge, because that's always going to be a part of his game. But living, you know, on the right side of the edge is very important. He had, again, for most of the game, he looks like he's been playing pro for many years. And there's still some moments that he needs growth. He's 18. He's going to be just fine.
Last Open Cup game, you kind of played a question mark. You didn't know what North Carolina was going to bring coming into it. This week, the team got thrown something that you couldn't have prepared for. How do you think they reacted?
Yeah, a new formation that we weren't expecting, and frankly, we weren't expecting their first team. I thought they would bring a second team or a mixed bag, but they, you know, give them credit. They did that, and again, I think what you saw with them is a renewed commitment. You know, yeah. Coach gets let go, and a new guy comes in, even on an interim basis, and changes some things, and that can gel a group to work, you know, a little extra harder. And again, they were tough to break down today. They were very tough to break down. Having said that, I thought we did, you know, even when they were organized. I thought some of our combination play, some of our build-ups, some of the times we pressed and turned them over. It was a very good game from us, and it's disappointing not to get the win.
You obviously had the schedule in your favor with who you could decide to suit up. They obviously play on Saturday, and like you said, you see more of their first teamers than maybe you would have expected. You talk about wanting to do things to help push the Open Cup, but is this a sign that more and more teams are taking this competition more and more seriously?
I think so. I think there's money for the players. There's good money for the players to win this thing. There's only two nights of the year for most of us teams, most of the teams, that you can have a night of glory, right?
Right.
You know, I've only had one night of feeling that, and it was in an Open Cup, and it was a wonderful night. It's still a great tournament. I still think it can be tweaked and pushed a little further. I'm disappointed we're out, but we're out and we'll move on.